So, letzte Last View to the Refugio Madonna della Neva. And here's the Diratissima going, here on the left side, by the way. yesterday, there were also the horses, perhaps it was on video, perhaps not, I'm not sure. But at the end, they broke my walking sticks here. One of the horses stepped on the sticks. Luckily, it broke really on top, so that it's only 5 cm shorter now, or 10 cm shorter. But I still can use it. This carbon sticks. It's now 135 and not 140 anymore. So it's still possible to use them. my voice is a little bit rough today because I don't know. And what I wanted to say, I don't know. Yeah, we start in a new day here, and this time we go to Europa. Here's the settlement. By the way, there are so many mosquitoes here again. It's good to leave here, and it's unbelievable. We also have seen the wolves. There are more dogs than wolves, whatever. And they look only a little bit like wolves. And here's another settlement, and you can see here on the left side that this is also perhaps some kind of weekend house for the more wealthy people from Milano or Torino, whatever, here. And we walk now through the woods there. There's the woods starting. And before there is a well, and we also have to fill up the bottles with the water. And then we go here around the corner through Rosazza. And then all the way up the mountains, it goes a long way up to Europa, to the pass and then to Europa. And the owner of the refugio said it's 12 kilometers. Oh, there's a coffee machine, and the coffee machine yesterday stood there. And even the last time when I was here, the coffee machine was there. Now it's falling down, whatever. Here, the old houses here, you can see how they collapse more and more in 10 years or whatever. There's nothing there anymore, except a pile of rocks. And in 10 years more, you wouldn't see that there was once houses. And they were occupied here for hundreds of years. This is a changing landscape here, which will be never like it was before. I said we are the last visiting them this year. Yeah, and then it's over. So I will show you the well where we get our drinking water. This is at the beginning there of the woods. And then we walk through the woods. And yesterday evening, there were even the way we were walking down here through the woods to the valley. It takes 1.5 hours normal hiking time here and down. And the record for running up here from down the valley, from Rosazza to here, to Refugio Madonna della Neva, is, you wouldn't think about, but the record is 24 minutes. 24 something minutes, that's the record. It's unbelievable, you run here up 24 minutes, when it takes 1.5 hour to walk down here. And there were even people coming late in the evening, running up here, training, whatever. Really fit people, and when it was dark, they ran down. Also, and this was a little bit crazy, because look at the road here, and this is not even the beginning of the woods. And if you fall here, running even, I don't know, and then you fall your left, whatever. that's a little bit risky, let's say. It's hot in the sun here with my long clothes. I had really a good sleep there. A good sleep. So, there's the well in the distance. You can see it, perhaps. And then we will refill now our bottles. It's a little bit muddy here. Yeah, with nice drinking water. So this is the road where we came from here. And this is not the final village where we have to go here, Rosazza. There is still a while to go. Was it cutted or eaten? Not clearly visible. And here the old iron stove. At the end, this here is some weekend residence perhaps. And currently there are not so many. Here I think. And last time when I came through, there were much more people going through here. GTA. And I wanted to show you a little bit how it looks if you go through such a village. 1932. You can see that it looks much younger, with a different construction style here. And the other ones have still the old construction style with loose rocks. There's the compagnon. There's a church. There's another chapel with the black Madonna. You can see there. There's a black Madonna, whatever, with the black child. And there's old benches here. 1967. Benches. So the compañero. What is it here? I don't see anything. There's something inside. There are some clouds. It's not too bad because it's really hot here. It's a nice made house here. Oh, there's even a QR code here. What a huge QR code here. And there's a complete program. Data information what you can download here. Or what you get at the end on this storage. There's another black Madonna. Storage sign. What was this? That was an alarm signal. Erster Companiero. Then right side, yeah. That's the correct way here. By the way, there are not so many mosquitoes here in the village anymore than in the woods. In the woods, this was really crazy. And this remembers me also that there was many. Oh, what's this? Jesus, I stepped on a dead mouse. I stepped on a dead mice here. That everything was full with mosquitoes last time. There you can see old things. Yeah. I still film a little bit here. Oh, there's a thermometer. 21. This is okay. In the shadow, it feels really cold. Not cold, but okay. Because I have my long clothes on. But in the sun is really hot. I think I have to remove my long shirt. But then you can choose between getting bitten every 10 seconds by a mosquito or too hot. What would be your choice? That's a church. More a chapel. And by the way, at the end of this day tour, we will visit one of the biggest churches in the world. That's then a Basilica Superiore. Oh, that's an old metal. Everything collapsed here. It was covered in wood structure. And then this collapsed here. Oh, this was the kitchen. And there were even some glasses and whatever in the everywhere, pan and whatever, everything full equipped, and there's even oven. This is what I say, it's a scenery. Wow, I was catched here by a plant which is undergoing. Look at the nice stone table. Last time I remember, there were here some everywhere people. Now there's no one. What was it, Sunday? It was Monday. Strange, perhaps it was holiday time. But today there's no one. There's the companiero. Okay. It's hot here. But I will remove my shirt now. That's too hot here in the sun. Now you can see here such a mountain road again. What was the name for it? I forgot the name. What I spoke in the last videos a lot about them, but it's always impressive how well maintained they are still after hundreds of years usage. And you can see This is full with the rocks, everything. This is 2 meters high here, and sometimes even 3 meters high here, for example. And these were once main connections between some major areas. Families worked on it, had to work on it. And this here is, for example, really high. But if you do such things over decades, over centuries, then you have here really a nice maintained road. And here this was not full with gravel, I've seen it once. Also in much better areas, it's really flat everything, with flat rocks. Here for example, that's more flat, this part. Normally you don't have loose rocks here lying around, this from winter. And you can see here how flat everything is, this here, this part for example. And you see also how wide it is. And it was easily possible, perhaps, to go with your horse. I don't know if these barriers were always here, or if there was something else that you can drive with your horse car. Oh, there's a hiker coming. And you can see here this part. This is still in good condition here, everything flat, but you can imagine that it was somewhere earlier much more flat, but perhaps it was not possible to drive with your horse car here up because of these barriers everywhere. This is against water erosion, that there's no river forming at the end on the road here. But look how high this is on the right side. But definitely you could take your horse. And there's even stairs here on the right side. So perhaps there was also here a... fields here. On here you can see the stairs. Directly constructed during construction of this road here. And this is so much work, and this is all disappearing step by step, everything here full with it, but this is disappearing in some decades time. There's nothing left perhaps, but the Italians are still maintaining this here. Some major roads for hiking, for example, they maintain this. And here, for example, you have such a rock slide here in front of us, where simply the rock slide is step by step destroying such constructions. That's the way all the things go into the second law of thermodynamics. Dissipation. Everything will dissipate, perhaps form something new, but it will dissipate. Perhaps there was someone on the bridge here. Some men, I mean. And there's again stairs here. On the right side. But one is missing, or two. Below. Or it was once higher here on the right side. Could be also possible, because this is a river area. It was perhaps once higher. Oh, Jesus, here. There's still some rocks here, for some reason. And there's also some rocks, so perhaps it was a channel here. There's a channel going, an old channel. So this was definitely a farming area here. There's an old farming area. You can already not see anything really, only if you look close, some old remains of the farming area. But we are now close to the village here, so this is clear. Yeah, and this, you can see the rock walls there. This was once made, a channel. I don't know how they moved the big rocks. So this goes now up here via Adua. This is a church, LED lighting. And look at this. Last time I was not able to film it here because there was a guide, and here are so many details here everywhere. This is, by the way, a really brand new door, very very expensive such a door. Here, stairs goes upstairs here. Here on the right side, there's some kind of tower. In Italy, you have everywhere something. It is even wheelchair accessible here. Jesus, look at the shoes here. Hiking shoes. But they look in a good condition, the hiking shoes here. They are like brand new. Wheelchair. This is a little bit steep. Oh, the slope for the wheelchair. I don't know where the companiero is. But I think you can't get lost here too much. Where's the companiero? Oh, we want off the dog. Only this one road here. Should be somewhere here, I hope. And then it goes here through. Yeah. Door painted. Okay, now it goes here through the garden area. Oh, Jesus. Look at this here. There's facilities here everywhere. These are beans, like we have. Climb beans. Climb beans. So. And we have to go now here. Through the garden property. Could also come from there. This would have been the shorter way from the church, I think. And here this is a little bit trees. There's a bench some kind. It's closed and today is no one here really. Last time I was here there was really everywhere people. Today is no one. And we are then already out of this small village. This building looks much newer. Yeah, this is, I think, most properties from more wealthy. There are some people doing something. A Milanese going in the mountains. Having some holidays here. Oh, this is really constructed in the rock there. In Italy, there's always so much detail everywhere. Here, something written somewhere, somehow. This is some kind of tent. And now, it goes up several kilometers. Oh. Look at these nice red fruits. I think they don't mind if I borrow some. And then we are in the woods. again. That's a shelter, which I have also filmed, I think, the last time. And we have been there on top. And there's indeed a room, you can go inside. Some kind of shelter, old shelter. Here even below, for some more people. And there above, there are some even some chairs, there's a table inside. And a oven, even not in good condition, and this is also not really in good condition here below, but this must be really old, perhaps 200 years old.
1984.
No. Can't be 1984. Where?
Inside.
1984?
Yeah.
Perhaps the part above?
Maybe.
80?
Yeah.
But this was only and carved something in the walls, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. This must be older here below. Much older. And there's also written something here. I see now. Pentier. Pentier. Here. Can read this only from the distance. But this is, I think, from the old times somehow. Really a shelter. Especially perhaps in the winter. Naja, okay, let's go then. So we are walking here the serpentines up, and you can see we are much higher now already. A little bit more. And then on the right side you can see that we have to go over this pass there. And then we are on the other side in the Europa Valley. What's the time? 2. It's perhaps 1 hour till the pass there. Should be 1 hour. And then, and by the way, somehow the description here is completely wrong, telling you that you need only 3 hours from below, from Rosaza to Europa. Perhaps this is 3 hours to the pass. It's definitely not 3 hours to Europa, because you need on the other side down already 1-2 hours to go to Europa. So we go now through the woods here. Yep. That goes away through the woods here. Direttissima, so that we don't have to go through the... Is it here?
No.
It still says that there is a trail. I think the trail is not anymore. Last year I went here through, definitely here. It's gone. There where the trees are, I think. Yeah, okay. And there's even the sign still left here. Okay. So. That's the road here. And there's some house there. And this was really exhaustive here. molto exhaustivo because of all the insects, mosquitoes, which were attacking us, and I also had a break attacking me. What's the name for this in English?
I don't know.
In German, it's a break. And there you can see we are a little bit higher now than the Alpe on the ridge there. In the background is the Po flatness, the Po plateau, I think it's called. And we still have to go up there, and even a little bit beyond higher. And then we are over the pass, and then the next station is Europa. Are you ready?
Yeah. How long is it?
There's a sign.
Still 1 hour.
I think it's still 1 hour, because the signs are not correct here. There's not even a... No, there's a time. Now it says 25 minutes to the Colle. It says from the beginning there are 3 hours till Europa. And it's still 1 hour 10. I think it said 3 hours when it was 10, and we have now 2:15.
Yeah, but we had a break.
Yeah, we had a break, but it's still 1 hour 10 to Europa from here, but that's not correct. Absolutely not correct, because you need from the Colle also minimum 1 hour, I would say. And it's not 25 minutes to the Colle, to the... You even can't see it from here. It's not 25 minutes, it's 1 hour, I would say. It's 2:15, let's see. It's also very steep, and you can see this here. It's really steep going up. Wow. My
caterpillar
there. And I rescued it. I don't know why they wanted to eat it. That was the reason for attacking the caterpillar. And I rescued it here into the bush. And now it's climbing here through the bush somehow. Yeah, but there's a road here on the left side. Yeah, they're still here. The ants traveling here a little bit. Here not. Naja, anyway, we go now. So we have again here mosquitoes coming. This is perhaps because of the sheep, which are
a goat.
And there's a dog, and the dog was even 10 meters in front of us. But I raised the sticks and made them as large as possible, and the dog ran away. This was really... Perhaps it is a stupid dog, but I've never seen a dog running like this. Only from this simple method. And this worked also with the companion. You can see it's, he ran completely away from there, from the hut there. Now he's scared of us. So there's a Colle, the pass in front of us, not too far anymore, perhaps 15 minutes. And then we are on top of the pass on the ridge here. Into another valley. Look how beautiful this is here. This is direction Po flatness, Milano, Turin, whatever there is. And we came here from around the corner at the end of this valley here. Valley. Not too far anymore. And then we have reached our destination. Oh, here was also a rock slide. Really fresh rock slide. Careful, companero. I'm the problem always.
Yeah.
And now I film also my thing. But this looks good here. Jesus, mosquitoes are coming again. That's horrible. And someone said, do not take repellent with you. I hope that we can get something in Europa, because I remember that when The last day, when it went down, this was horrible. Again, additionally to the 2000 meter descent, it was also that everything was attacking me. I couldn't do a break, I remember. It was impossible to make even a break, a short break. And even if it was down, it was really exhaustive. Where's the dog?
There are a lot of goats.
I think, there. There's the dog. The dog is so scared that he completely ran away. He's there together. No, we ran again because the companion is making the. Don't scare him.
This was such a funny trick, you know. I think that only the dog.
Okay, the last meters, and then we see us again from top of the ridge there. Now this is, by the way, the trail there. It goes there. You from the top you can see it. If you are hiking there from below, you can see nearly nothing, but it's there. Going up there to the hut. That's a nice view, by the way. Now on top of the ridge here, there's a bird falling down. You can even climb there, the mountain. And there, again, the view to Europa in this nice ray of light there. The Basilica Superiore of Europa. And tomorrow we go there in this direction, in this valley there. Up in the mountains, you can see this is much higher, the mountains there behind. This here is at the end, relatively tall, small mountains. There it's much, much taller behind. And we go tomorrow 2500 meter again. Today this is only 1600 here. What's the sign saying? That's Santuario di Giovanni Adorno. This is at the end, a little bit further down. What's this here? Ritorno a Europa. This is down and back here. Why should you do this? I don't know. Because there's the Po flatness there. In this direction, everything is flat. You can see that this is the last mountains here going flat down. More everything, and would be perhaps a nice view there from top of this mountain. Everything going flat. Milano, Torino, whatever. But we are going in this direction where it's much higher, where the clouds are tomorrow. And tomorrow this will be exhaustive again, up to 2500 meter. And we stay there overnight in the Refugio Coda. Ah yeah, another thing. There is here the sanctuary of the Black Madonna, which you can already see here also. There's even the big version. Oh, there's the Pope here. The old Pope. The Pope, even before the Pope, the retired Pope. Oh, I don't know why they greet like in Buddhism. What's this for a sign there? That's a little strange. They make some signs here, which I don't understand. Hmm. 20. There's even something written here. Gloriosa. Huh. Naja.
This is even closed here, everything. That you do not steal here in the Madonna. This is the Madonna is cemented here on a piece of rock. What is this there? What are the pipes here? I don't know what these pipes are. Who knows? Oh, there's even, look at this. There's even a mortar. Mortar, whatever it is called. And here, such a plastic lawn. And here is some kind of a slip or whatever here lying down. No, shoot. And we go now down here in this direction through the woods there again. And I really hope that there's not any mosquitoes anymore attacking us, because they really attacked us here through the woods. This was horrible. Here above the woods was okay, but in the woods here below, this was absolutely horrible with all the mosquitoes. And compañero, I know there is connection now here, but we should go now to the to our next refugio there, which you can see here below. Yeah, see you then.